Hello, my fellow Whovians and subscribers. Welcome to my latest Doctor Who review, where today I review The Face of Evil, starring Tom Baker and Louise Jameson. So, The Face of Evil, this is the fourth story of season 14, Tom Baker's third season as the Doctor. And the basic plot of this story is as follows. The Doctor arrives on a planet where two tribes, the savage Sevatim and the technically brilliant Tesh, are at war. He meets Leela, an exile from the Sevatim, and discovers that their god of evil is apparently himself. There we go, that's the basic gist of The Face of Evil. Okay, The Face of Evil. Well, this was the story that was going to introduce the new companion, Leela, but also it was the story that was going to follow the magnificent Deadly Assassin story. Which saw Tom Baker basically on his own for most of that story. I've done a review of that, so that's my previous review. Check that out if you want to know my thoughts on that. But, I mean, genuinely speaking, it was magnificent. So, to come up with a follow-up story to that, for the next story in the season to follow that, was going to be a tough act to follow. And, of course, this story just doesn't hold up to that story. But that's not to say this story is bad. I like The Face of Evil. I think this is a good, decent Doctor Who story, but I wouldn't say it's anything more than that. It's a perfectly fun time, but really it's not the best or most inventive story that they've ever come up with. I do like the ideas in this story. I do like the fact that the Doctor comes across a planet where he himself has been programmed into this computer to believe that he is like the enemy, that this evil god or something, which is kind of intriguing, and it adds a lot of mystery to the story, and the mystery of the story is really quite interesting. And when the Doctor encounters Zoannan, the computer at the end, that is a pretty good sequence, and I do like the Doctor's confrontation there, and how he discovers his voice is inside the computer, his face is inside the computer, and obviously at the end of, I think it's the end of part one, actually, where he discovers a statue of himself, which is you know, in the land somewhere. Of course, this story introduces Leela, who will be the new companion for the next season and a half. Louise Jameson is good as Leela. Leela's a very different character to Sarah Jane. She's a warrior. She's a tribe warrior. She's more rough and violent than the Doctor probably would like. But my goodness me, Louise Jameson is a beautiful lady. Well, she was certainly a beautiful lady in those days. And she's pretty good. I mean, Leela's a good character, and I like her relationship with the Doctor. Obviously, we are yet to see more of it, but the beginnings of it are nice, and I think she instantly develops a nice rapport with him, and she actually trusts him because she is an exile. She's run away from her tribe because they're out to kill her for some reason, and the Doctor kind of befriends her instantly, and then she just joins him on the mystery to solve, which is interesting. God, I made it sound like Scooby-Doo there for a minute. But no, I think Louise Jameson is pretty good, and, you know, I can't deny, she rocks the outfit, you know, she really does. And I look forward to seeing more stories with her, because this is the first story I've seen her in. I've not seen the rest of the Tom Baker stories. I'm a first-time viewer reviewing these stories, so there. What really does stick out about this story is the production design. I think the sets look terrific. The land of the outside sort of jungle area where the Sevatim tribe are, that's really well done, and I think the sets look really good. And obviously when we get to the Tesh's you know, base or computer room or whatever you call it, that is a really good set as well, like with all the white corridors, and then the walls, I've got these great looking designs. It's as if the Doctor and Leela have stumbled upon the USS Enterprise or something like that from Star Trek. It looks like something like that, which is kind of odd and ironic, but it really does work actually for this story. For me, the story is not perfect though. I do think the pacing of the story drags a little bit, even though this is only four parts, but it's very talky. I think this is quite a talky story. There's not enough action in this story. It's not the most exciting story, not until, well, the end, really. The first half of the story is kind of slow, and I think that it would have been nice to have a bit more conflict and a bit more excitement between the Doctor, Leela, and the Savateen tribe, because all they do is kind of talk for most of that half, and it does start to drag a bit. But when we get to the Tesh's lair, that's when the story picks up, and it does start to get a bit more interesting. So I think the pacing could have been tightened up a bit. But it's a solid script, and I do, again, I like the idea of the computer and, you know, the Doctor encountering Zoannan, and instantly this story builds the rapport between Leela and the Doctor perfectly. The supporting cast, I guess, are decent. They're all kind of forgettable, really. They're all kind of basically one-dimensional characters. They're all pretty much the same. Neva, who is one of the villains, I suppose. He's this kind of, played by David Garfield, he's this kind of angry tribesman. Yeah, there's not much else to his character. Andor, played by Victor Lucas, I'll give him a shout out. Tomas, played by Brendan Price, he's good. He turns out to be, you know, he's quite a nice character. I quite liked him. Caleb, played by Leslie Schofield. Sol, played by Colin Thomas. Lugo, played by Lloyd McGuire. Those are the main ones. I really do like the voice of Zoannan, voices of Zoannan, I should say. There's four people credited with the voice of Zoannan, as well as Tom Baker as well. You know, they've taken audio from him as well, because the Doctor becomes the face of the computer. Rob Edwards, Pamela Salem, Anthony Fries, and Roy Herrick. All of them are credited as Zoannan, so good for them. They obviously provided good voices for this big computer. But as I say, the story is a bit slow, and I do think it could be tightened up in the pacing. There's too much talking. It starts to really drag, I think, at points. It's fun, though. I mean, there are some fun scenes, but I do feel there could have been a bit more action in the story in the first half. The second half is a lot better, and it does get more interesting, but the story itself, it's nothing special. I mean, it's certainly fun. It's good fun. But it to me, it's not as grand or groundbreaking. Certainly not as The Deadly Assassin. But it's not the most inventive story in the world. There is some good action in the second half of the story when Leela is firing the gun at the guards and the tribesmen. You know, she does a good job there. I mean, some of the effects are quite nice for the time, obviously. And I do quite like the music of this story. I think the music score works very well for the story. But the script by... Who did the script? Writer Chris Boucher. Chris Boucher's script is decent. It's solid. It works for what it is. I also love the comedy of this story with the beginning of the episode where the Doctor meets Leela, and then he offers her a jelly baby. He says, "Would you like a jelly baby?" And she says, "Oh, you are the evil one. They said the evil one ate babies." And he's like, "Oh no, it's a sweet. They're rather good, I must say." Or something like that. That was quite funny. I did like that. And also there's a funny moment where the Doctor is surrounded by a couple of tribesmen, the Savateen tribesmen. And then he holds up a jelly baby. And he's like, "Move now or I will kill you with this deadly jelly baby." I mean, that's really good. I can't remember the exact lines of the clip, but watch it on YouTube. It's a very funny scene. That's the funniest scene of the story. So it's nice to see Tom Baker have a bit more comedy in this story. And certainly after the story that was The Deadly Assassin, he was really giving it his all there. I mean, in this one, he's allowed to be a bit more looser and a bit more funny. Like I said, it's good fun. It's good fun. And it's directed by Pennant Roberts. I've never heard of that person before. The direction is decent. Yeah, it's fine. It works. It's good. No real major issues, just the pacing. Tighten up the pacing. And obviously, Philip Hinchcliffe, again, you know, he's a great producer, so I can't really complain there. But to sum it all up, I don't have much else to say about this one. It's good fun. I don't know if I'll ever revisit it anytime soon, but it's a good one. It's a good story. I mean, it was never going to be as good as The Deadly Assassin, but you know, if you love the story more than me, then that's fine. But this is just my honest opinion. I don't sugarcoat things. That's my one rule when I started to review things on this channel, was that I said I am never going to sugarcoat anything, because what's the point? You know, if you're going to review something, just be honest about it. It's your honest opinion. You know, don't do that. Don't sugarcoat things. Anyway, to sum it up, I'm going to give this story... I'll be nice, actually. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. I think it needs a bit of work, but generally speaking, it was good. It was a good story. It was solid. I'll give it that. Right, okay, so next time on Doctor Who Review, we look at The Robots of Death, which is the penultimate serial of this season, and then we'll be on to the The Talons of Weng Chiang, which is the season finale. So yeah, we're nearly 3 seasons down with Tom Baker, and then another 4 to go. But no, and welcome Leela. Welcome Leela. Woo! Look forward to the next story with Leela. I just want to start by giving a few shout-outs as well before I leave, just to say thanks to some subscribers who have meant a lot to me recently and have done a lot. Nicholas Payne, Sci-Fi Movie Talk, if you actually are watching this, Sam Harrison, Alan Kalo, Jack the Film Fanatic, and also a special mention to Harry Thomas. And a quick side note, Harry, if you're watching this, I am so sorry for what you're going through. I won't say personally what you are going through for your own discretion, but I will just say, you know, everything I've said in my messages, I stand by, and I hope you're doing okay, my friend. I'm really sorry for what you're having to go through. But anyway, thank you all for watching, and stay tuned next time when I review The Robots of Death. So until next time, I'm Mr. TARDIS 11. See you soon.